So here we sit, pretty much on, look, see that dude, we might be in trouble. Hey, do you have any fear of the unknown?
Yeah, who doesn't?
What do you think would happen if we went down this hill?
We might flip.
All right, you want to try it?
Of course I do. That's a pretty steep hill.
I know, hold on. Okay, so I did turn, oh no, here we go. I did turn the camera around. Go. Oh! Ah! Oh, no. Oh! He's trying to kill us.
Do we want to see if it'll make it back up the hill? Look at that hill. Probably not as fast as the way up.
Yeah, I hope not.
I think I can.
Oh, boy. I had faith the whole time.
Oh, okay.
I don't know about you. I believed in you.
Okay.
He's gone. Okay, so I'm here with my friend Michael Pace today.
Hey.
And we're out having a little fun today on a Friday. Michael just got back from a little R&R and about 30 days worth. And so I wanted him to talk to you a little bit about his faith story. And his fear of the unknown. So, Michael, why don't you tell me the story about the man that you met while you were in Florida and the questions he asked you and then the answer that you found.
Well, he asked me, first of all, I preface with, I can tell you're a Christianly raised kid and you believe in Christianity, but you're missing one big thing. I said, I got it. I threw out an answer real quick. Obedience. He said, no, that's not it. You're gonna feel silly when I finally tell you the simple answer. And I started to ask him again. He said, no, I want you to think about it. Call me in the next few days when you figure out the answer. I'm not gonna tell it to you. Well, I went to sleep that night, and I had a dream that I was standing outside of the gates of heaven, and Jesus walked out and spit me out of his mouth and looked over at me and said, "Ye of little faith, I do not know who you are," and walked back in the gates. And I immediately woke up, and it was 7 o'clock in the morning, and I called my guy and I said, "Dude, I got the answer. Is it faith?" He said, "You got it, brother." I said, "Man, God's never spoken to me before." He said, "Well, congratulations, he just did."
It seems like you had a lot of fear about going to Florida. And here's the question, really. You weren't scared of Florida, were you?
No. Florida's awesome.
Okay, Florida's awesome. Did you trust that what people were telling you was the right thing?
The people themselves, yeah, they cared about me.
You weren't afraid of them, were you?
No.
Okay. And then the place where you were going, did you have any fear about that place?
No, it seemed really nice.
Okay.
I was afraid of finding out that everybody was right. I was afraid of coming to the realization that I had problems. I didn't want to be that way. I was fearful that my appraisal business would take a downturn with me being gone. I was fearful that people would look at me differently when I came back. A stigma, if you will. I was fearful of rumors. I was fearful of things not getting taken care of in my absence. Normal everyday things, the kids, the yard getting cut, you name it, just all the worthless anxiety.
You were afraid of what you didn't know.
I was scared of what I didn't know.
Okay. Gone. How'd all that work out for you?
Wonderful. Amazingly well. Everything was taken care of while I was gone.
I came back to multiple appraisal orders, came back to a job that was really excited to see me, came back to a mowed yard, came back to a great family that were anxious to see me and welcomed me with open arms. So, yeah, it all worked out for the best.
You just gotta have faith.
I just had to have faith that God would take care of everything, and he did.
And tell me, awesome. So what would you say to people that are afraid of the unknown?
I would tell them that just go, God will take care of the rest.
Okay, so in other words, let me put that, see if you can put that in other words for me. So if you in your life have fear of the unknown, then what should you have?
Faith. Faith in God that he'll take care of you in any situation.
Even when you're scared to death.
Even when you're scared to death. More when you're scared to death. Get on your knees. Pray.
Just as a side note, as you can tell, the greens are in really nice shape here today. Why don't you go ahead and drain this?
I think I will. It might bounce a few times.
Oh, how did that not go in?
One could call this stupidity. One could call this faith.
See it? Oh, that's good.
Boys and girls, golfing can be dangerous.
That bullfrog will eat you.
Look at that lizard.
You know, Phil being Phil.
There it was. 'Cause I gotta have faith. I gotta have faith.